fucked it up. Got around to reviewing Battlefield 4, which sucks because I'm a huge fan of the series, but I was so pissed off at its release.
What am I looking at?
Are you fucking serious? No, okay.
You know what I've had enough of, EA? Is your fucking bullshit. That's what I've had enough of. Battlefield 4, you done fucked it up. You have to know, it's one of my favorite military first-person shooter franchises. But I felt so betrayed! Betrayal! From EA and DICE.
Fix this shit! Now!
Especially after dropping $120 in the games and hundreds more in servers for the Angry Army. Had I reviewed it then, it likely would have scored a 4 out of 10! For the state that it was in, and that would have been fair. It was pushed out the door clearly way too early, and now that it's had like almost a year and a half, it's the game that it should have been. It is far better than ever. In fact, in its current state, it's like a 9 or an 8 or a 9. It is great right now. If you missed out on it, I recommend buying Battlefield 4 and expansions rather than this, because this is even worse. I don't know why Battlefield does that. You'd have to click on it. Michael Bay to the nth degree there. And I'm about to explain exactly why, and I'm gonna convince you. After playing all of it from start to finish and taking my actual time with multiplayer, I can say without a doubt that Battlefield Hardline is one of the worst, easily one of the worst Battlefields released. And no, I'm not talking about its launch stability. At least they got the launch right this time. It's not a complete disaster online so far. Just, you know, a few bugs and connectivity issues here for any launch game. But, and the fucking annoying battle log. But relatively a solid launch. My issue is that Hardline feels exactly unnecessary, like an unnecessary spin-off from EA, done more for the purpose of cashing in on its fans. I mean, look at this shit. They duplicate the BF4 business model a second time, and again, charge $120 upfront day one for this game and its 4 in-development expansions. Well, I can tell you right now that this game isn't worth $120, not even close. Not even 70. Not even 60.
Are you gonna shoot him or no?
Whoa.
Clear.
Okay, and you didn't do jack shit about that? Did you see that? He went through the wall.
It's clever. I'll give him that.
You didn't shoot him. You were just gonna let him creep up on me. Location.
It's had its idea as a cops versus robbers game limited because it's supposed to be Battlefield when it could have very well been a completely new IP. But no, they needed to ride on the Battlefield name and give us another platform for selling those fucking battle packs. Ugh, I swear to God, if those fucking battle pack microtransactions are a part of the new EA DICE Star Wars Battlefront game, I will lose all hope. Let's start with why this game disappointed me so much. Single player first. And trust me, after this video, there's no possible way that you can defend this. The story here is only interesting if you have never seen any cop drama or cop movie in your life, because it is just about the most cliched, average, run-of-the-mill cop story there is. The same story. Dirty cops, extremely obvious double crossing, and quickly setting out for revenge.
More secure inside this shot than it is on the street.
I mean, it looks great here. It's technically sufficient, but what they're saying, the things that are coming out of their mouth, and the character interactions, I'm not caring yet.
You know, whereas they wanted to pay homage to compelling cop dramas, they ended up making an example of a bland and a generic one. The only cool thing is how diverse the cast is.
Starring Jose Antonio Vargas, not Nicholas Gonzalez. Who the fuck is Nicholas Gonzalez? It's starring Jose Antonio Vargas. Patrol officer.
Thankfully, they're not all buzz-cut white dudes abusing the power and shooting up everybody. They at least managed to stay away from that. But it's more like television. The levels have been renamed episodes. The entire layout reminds the player of network television. There's a previously on segment, and if you quit, there's a preview of what's on the next episode.
Next time on Hotline.
Good evening, detective.
Probably have questions.
I have a fuck ton of questions.
There is even a direct ripoff of the countdown to autoplay the next episode straight from Netflix. And I know because I'm currently going through Breaking Bad right now. It's exactly the same. Now, aside from that annoying screen where everything scrolls way too fast, I think this approach was novel. That's not the problem. That's not what to complain about. The problem is that despite spending considerable time setting up the characters in many hands-off or limited interaction sections during the epilogue in like the first three episodes, you just never really grow to care about anybody by the end.
Evening Tap, don't run because I will chase you. We're looking for Tyson.
You her new partner?
She do that karate for you yet?
I study Krav Maga. Karate's mystical bullshit.
You are a trip.
Tap and
karate
Tyson
is mystical bullshit?
White guys who got a taste for the hood. Tap what? Never left.
But that's not for the lack of trying, though. The devs have stated they wanted the game to be more character-driven rather than strictly following some, you know, canned storyline. And it does this. But the characters we get, although expertly voice acted and they're convincing, they're just not interesting or compelling. Do you know what I'm saying? It doesn't help here that the writing was weak. That's what it is. Terrible one-liners.
Wingman Leo? Not smart.
Who's he?
Found him on the way to the zoo. Said he wanted to see something endangered.
Can you fucking believe this?
Not a single joke, aside from one crazy self-referential parody, like a video game parody, made me even crack a smile or laugh.
Detective, do you know this man?
Oh, him? He does spreadsheets.
And during one of these slower setups intended to allow for, you know, banter and atmosphere, you're walking through the streets in the ghetto calmly at night, and I really enjoy this part, but, you know, after a while you realize how linear it is, and you're like, it just made me wish for something more.
Dude, this just makes me want a cop game that is like, you know, fucking open world and dynamic, where, like a Grand Theft Auto, but for police. Cops the video game, yeah, man. I lost my partner! Oh, fuck, it's training day! I'm gonna whip out my gun right here, I'm fucking scared. Stay back! Stay back, you crack whore!
Single player is gonna take you only about 6 to 7 hours to complete, during which things never really kick into like episode 5 till you're halfway through the thing and there's only 10 missions. Before that, it's just dull and boring. I had to keep myself entertained by acting like I was a much more interesting cop, RoboCop, or Robo Joe to be more specific.
Hands up.
Brace.
Okay, I'm cool.
Not looking for trouble. He's reaching! You crazy!
Stop! Or there will be trouble. I am made of titanium. I don't believe you are.
I got him over here!
You ain't got shit. Arrest him!
Have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law.
For every okay episode, like where you fight what seems like the entire Miami criminal population at some dude's mansion, like fucking up all his nice shit in his house in the process.
What kind of an asshole lives in a place like this?
A rich asshole. A rich Hollywood asshole.
Scratch his fucking car.
Mendoza, knock it off.
That's not gonna fuck. You're not gonna hear that. I just scratched his car. Can't do nothing up in here. I can't do nothing.
There's a crap one. Like driving, or should I say skating around the swamp, fucking tagging floating drugs. Duck Dynasty style.
You wanna get on the captain's good side? Take the gloves off.
Oh, is that what this is? Bare knuckle police work?
Now you're catching on.
And every once in a while stopping off to kill some generic bad dudes. And get this, they had to include the extremely obviously telegraphed alligator QTE attack.
Okay, I'll pull up to the dock.
A lot of gators out here.
Yeah, I wouldn't sweat it. They're more afraid of us than we are of them.
Oh, look, there's some drugs over here, man.
God, Battlefield for some reason still feels the need to live up to Call of Duty's insane set piece levels and never-ending unfolding chaos, even here in a smaller lower-key cop setting. So when Hardline does this, it feels completely out of place and fucking ridiculous.
Stop right there!
Go, go!
Am I flying around on a helicopter?
Holy shit!
Take him out!
Fuck! Take him out!
You all right?
I just fell out of
the- Hit him!
Now, I don't even know how they did it, but they managed to include a fucking AC-130 mission and a tank battle.
Which means I'm gonna kill you, chop off your heads, and piss down your necks.
Where the fuck are the cops or the National Guard? This doesn't just fucking happen. What the fuck? Seriously? Nobody hears this?
He ran out of smoke screen!
I don't care about a smoke screen, I know
he's
exactly
running.
Where he is.
His tank stalled! He called the more choppers!
Why is his tank invulnerable?
Smoke's cleared up! Boomer! I got Albert!
Alright. And the world thanks you.
So I just killed that. Was that like supposed to be like an interesting battle where like you drive your tank around and you shoot him and then you shoot helicopters? Because when you put two tanks like together like that, I'm just gonna shoot that tank over and over. He pops smoke and he pops smoke. Oh well, then I can't shoot him. And I guess that's his defensive boss thing. No, I don't. Is this just like a checkbox? Does this just like check? Oh, we need one of those levels that Modern Warfare had. Yes, that's exactly it. As if they're just like trying to check a bunch of fucking boxes. And when you do that, you create a by the numbers cookie cutter game that's not interesting. Be original. Do something different. Like you were kind of doing at the beginning.
Miami PD.
The real meat of this game has a lot more stealth than you expect because of the new arrest mechanic, which basically means on PC you press the awkwardly placed G, you know, from ASW, you press G, that you can't remap to shout freeze, which will automatically freeze up to three enemies and make them drop their weapons. You only need to keep your gun pointed at them or risk a red meter filling, which will have them draw their guns on you.
Freeze. Everybody freeze!
What?
Oh, get this out!
I did that on purpose. Just give me a reason, punks. Give me a reason. You saw them. They were drawing.
Anyway, once you get used to it, it's an easily exploitable system, but still fun and different enough from what I normally play to be cool.
Oh, I saw that hand. Don't do it, son. You value your life. Now, I'm gonna just look at this evidence over here and oh, what are you doing with that hand, son? You eating Chinese food here? What is this? You sneaky bastard.
Unfortunately, they even fucked this up by not keeping it fresh. After the first few episodes are arresting people, it gets boring and repetitive as fuck. It's the same thing every time. Suspects even say the same lines and make the same grunts over and over.
Hands up. Keep them up.
Son of a...
Shut up, boo.
Yeah, yeah, no problem.
Get on the ground. Oh, yeah.
Criminals don't at all act this way. Why the hell would some of these hardened, hired mercenaries ever surrender right when they're pointing their guns at you, you know, full machine guns and body armor to you who has this dinky little pistol? Especially when you're no longer even a freaking cop later on in the game. And why is there no mentally unstable psychos who respond to freeze with a hail of gunfire or, you know, taking off their clothes and running around naked? You can't get me, coppers! You can't get me! Why not?
I'm not gonna tell you again. Sit down on the curb.
And what are you doing? Don't be grabbing on me. I just asked you.
You're gonna get tased if you don't sit down.
I ain't getting that to you. I'll get you, bitch. Get on the ground. Turn around.
Okay, maybe not the last one, but you get the idea. Cop work is completely unpredictable. Not this canned animation garbage. And do I have an endless supply of handcuffs? And these guys, why the fuck are they sitting there quietly instead of screaming out to alert their buddies, I'm under arrest, come kill this motherfucker?
Freeze. Don't fucking move.
Whoa, whoa, you got it.
Shh! Be quiet! Don't say anything. I know that you could literally just say, hey guys, he's over here, while you're handcuffed, but apparently you're too fucking stupid to do that.
And for that, I thank you, idiot.
The enemy AI is complete crap and laughably easy on all but the hardline mode, which you have to unlock by first beating the whole fucking thing. And don't even get me started on your partner's AI.
Yeah, shoot him. Shoot him. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49, 50, 51, 50. Wow, man, this dude is a fucking RoboCop. It's the real RoboCop right here. Holy shit, boy. What's the point in... Oh, boy. What are you fucking shooting at him, BBs? I think they're tickling him. He's ticklish. Stop tickling him. Oh, my God! He can actually die?
I don't know. Maybe it'll be...
So it... What the fuck was that?
Oh, shit. They cut the power.
Completely rebuilt AI. My ass! More like completely work in progress, unfinished AI slapped together to hide some deficiencies. It's fucking terrible. How did nobody notice this? Why is this not mentioned in any fucking review? More puzzlingly, playing this good cop and arresting people, keeping them alive, gives you points to unlock new weapons, which only the bad cops would use to kill everything that moves. It is contradictory. Most of the guns you unlock feel unneeded after you find one. If you play a good cop, you should get better varieties of non-lethal devices and takedowns instead of more guns that you're not even gonna fucking use. Who let this through? This design is stupid. And all the rest of these cop mechanics completely fall on their face. There is no meaningful purpose for any of these.
Here. Yeah.
The pancake man. Do it.
I don't even want to know what the fuck that is.
Interesting. I think I solved the case. I solved the case with that.
This is almost as interesting as the Order's pictures where you look at the...
Investigating via your police scanner feels tacked on and superficial at best. Nobody can defend it.
I'm guessing it was Leo.
This is stupid. That fucking mechanic is... It's not interesting. There's no point in scanning it. You can just walk in here and she could just say it, you know?
It would have been pointless if it wasn't tied to the awful case file system where you find little pieces of evidence by looking at them that unlock the new varieties of weapons through 15 elite system ranks. But by the time you unlock what you want at level 11 or 13, the game is fucking over. And trust me, this campaign doesn't really beg to be played again. Don't buy Battlefield for single player, fine! But you're gonna be real fucking pissed off if you spent this kind of money for its multiplayer. Cause it's even more of a misfire than single player. And I'm gonna explain exactly why you are gonna be so fucking shocked. Almost none of the unique mechanics in the campaign for the cop flavor carry over into multiplayer as the devs decided to play it safe and essentially create a Cocky Duty reskin of BF4. That's what it is. It's a Cocky Duty reskin, and you can quote me on that. Only here, it's horribly restrictive and limiting while attempting to fit into this cops and robbers theme. Just Battlefield, just trying to shove it into a pole that doesn't fit. Disgusting!
All right, just ignore him. Now look through this window. Look through these windows.
Okay. Nice! Oh, check it out. There's a guy. What the fuck? This bulletproof.
Yeah, they kind of forgot about programming that window, I guess.
Team Deathmatch and Conquest are pale comparisons to what they once were, and nobody can deny that. Teamwork seems less of a priority amongst these classes, and without proper tanks and vehicles and attack helicopters, Conquest is completely neutered. You know, if they wanted to follow the script and do nothing to change these modes and just be cops and robbers, why not make them more like they should have been? Put in more tanks and shit. A real drug war. All you'd have to do is set it in the jungles of Colombia or Peru and have the enemies be more like fucking cartel than little petty looking criminals ripped straight from GTA Heist or Payday. Add fucking tanks and helicopters, go crazy. No, instead, like the game itself, it went for generic cops versus robbers instead of a cool ass filthy drug war. Such wasted potential.
That's a nice ass house.
Yeah. Nice ass waterfall.
Yeah.
Make it for you. It'd be a shame if something were to happen to it.
Don't do it!
No!
Damn! That's a strong ass waterfall. Grenade proof.
And so many wonder why people call this game a simple, low effort reskin. And they are charging you the same price as BF4, saying this game is as good as BF4, has as much content as BF4. That's not fucking true. And evidently, the community agrees with me because already peak player counts are higher on BF4 than they are on Hardline, and this is launch release everywhere, except for Xbox and PS4. And that's because they are desperate for any new game on those consoles. Even if it's only running at 780p on Xbox One and 900p on the PS4? No wonder people think the game looks like crap, or at least doesn't look as good as it should. How is this possible, EA, in 2015? Is it the consoles? Or is it the effort put into development? I don't understand. Thankfully, they do attempt some unique modes in Blood Money and Heist. Blood Money is usually a clusterfuck in the middle of the map with not much of the rest of the map used, but I love it because it brings a lot of action there in the middle, and players attempt to steal money from the, like, a money pile and bring it back to their own separate money piles at their base. It's basically like Capture the Flag style.
I can get this kid a ride. He just doesn't want to ride, I guess.
Please, guys.
Heist, though, is probably my favorite. Large, multiple player heists require players to cooperate to attempt to break into a vault, steal the objectives, and take them to designated drop-off points, escaping. It feels like an awesome version of the movie Heat, especially on the bank job level. Thank God the sound design in Battlefield is as good as ever. It sounds so beautiful. The cracking of sniper fire when you're under stress. The fucking echoes of gunfire both inside buildings and outside buildings has this throaty just echo. It just sounds so goddamn orgasmic.
Oh, come on, game. Let me do a little bit of shooting. Oh, there we go. Oh, whatever. But the second you aim, like, that's so crazy. Alright, fine.
But apparently you had too many developers recording gun sounds rather than working on these smaller game modes, these esport competitive modes, called Rescue and Crosshair. And I didn't get to play these too much because on PC, nobody's really hosting servers with just 10 slots, right? But however, I did get an entire day of eventually playing them in Quick Match. These are 5v5 matches with no response. Where you either escort a VIP or you save a hostage.
Yeah, I think we're definitely gonna be better on going to B. So just get to the building right here.
Guys, this is Crosshair. Check it out.
So I'm throwing a smoke.
Nobody on thermal.
Come on, thermal here. Yeah, keep going. Going up in the building. Going up in the building. Hold on.
Still nothing on thermal.
Nothing in the building.
And we win.
Woo! Congratulations. What an awesome, awesome mode. That's hilarious.
The maps. There are zero maps designed for this mode. And you need maps specifically designed for it. Basically, you have five players, one of them is a VIP, and they need to get to one of two extraction zones. And all they need to do is stand in an extraction zone for like 2 seconds and they win.
Like in the back middle and there was only one of them? Okay, there's two exit spots. That's a lot of content. Like why? How can you cover both of them?
There's five of us. Why are there two fucking exits? That's so stupid.
Well.
Wow, that thing fills up way too fast!
You don't even get points. Like, look at my points. This is like, I'm only getting the points because I'm getting out. I feel like if you didn't get out, you'd get nothing.
They are just sections of the bigger maps that everybody's already played on. They don't at all lend themselves well to the mode. This leads to people just exploiting the maps and just rushing the points because it's ridiculously easy to. Every map we played on in rotation was awful.
I have never seen a more poorly designed map for a mode like this. This is absolutely hilarious.
Pretty lazy.
It's
who this I bet you people that mod games could make a better fucking mod or map for this mode than
those just
than
port Counter Strike maps. It would work though, that's what's great.
Don't let that punk get there.
I can't believe nobody has mentioned this. It's indefensible. I don't know what it's like on consoles, but that's what it is on PC. Now, Rescue fares a bit better, but playing both of these modes, you can't help but feel like you're playing a crappier version of Counter-Strike with far less effort put into them and cheesy tactics dominating the charts right now with smokes and infrared scopes and fucking shotguns that shoot across a goddamn map or way too far. There's no fucking team balancing shit right now for those two modes when so few people play them. You failed. If you wanted to create game modes for esports and competitive gaming, you failed horribly. And that needs to be noted. The much lauded and most popular mode, Hotwire, is broken. It completely breaks the progression in multiplayer. All you need to do is grab a vehicle and drive around in circles. Hey, sound fun? This is what you'll be doing in Battlefield Hardline the majority of the time in multiplayer. Whee! Oh yeah, this is what I think of when I think of my Battlefield experience. Yeah, let me turn on the fucking jam there. Oh, yeah, motherfucker. Battlefield. Yeah. What the fuck?
Damn, you're right, man. All you guys to do is drive around a car. I'm now third.
And you get a shitload of points.
Yeah, let's unlock everything in the game like this.
That's what I'm gonna do.
My problem isn't with the driving itself, but the amount of points you get for driving around in circles is absolutely ridiculous. You can unlock everything in the game within a few hours without fucking earning it. It needs to be reduced. But it's already too fucking late for that. And that shit was in beta, and all the popular Twitch streamers, I was watching them, complained about it and mentioned it, and did EA fix it? Absolutely not. It is still completely unbalanced. Is it fun from time to time to drive around and to stick your body out of the window and shoot? Yes, it is, but it needs to be fixed. Oh, shit!
The car exploded. Yes, it did, Otaku girl.
The enemy team is not even trying to get the cars.
No, I don't think they know what's going on, actually.
Now, I guess one cool thing here in Hardline is that you can use the money that you earn from that doing that and the other six modes to purchase unlocks across the board for class-specific weapons, allowing you to pick and choose your favorite weapon and buy it sooner. But then why can't we use different guns for different classes like we could in BF4? There is barely any content here, and this is the biggest problem in multiplayer, and players are starting to realize it. If nothing else convinced you, this will. Let me show you this. And keep in mind, the entire time they're charging the same exact price as BF4, saying it's just as good and just as content filled. Check this shit out.
Okay, guys, this is it. I'm going to show you an apples-to-apples comparison from Battlefield Hardline to BF4 and what you're getting in each. Okay, so let's look at Battlefield Hardline. I'm going to go to the loadout. Let's just choose Mechanic as a starting point. Do Primary Weapon. Guess how many weapons the Mechanic has? Four. Four fucking weapons, and that's it. These other four that you see here, these are police weapons, and the top are criminal weapons. In order to use one type on the other type, you have to get 1,250 kills with the weapon. So really, there's only four types of weapon for your class, and unless you can spend something like 10 to 20 hours unlocking us, and that's for each of these additional weapons. So really, you're only looking at about four, eight maximum if you spend weeks on the game. Okay, so now let's go and check out Battlefield 4. Let's choose Engineer to make sure we're doing apples to apples. You have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 weapons, not counting the DLC weapons. But oh, what's this? You have carbines. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, not counting the DLC. 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32. You get the point. Look at all of these weapons that you get in Battlefield 4 versus what you get in Battlefield Hardline.
Battlefield Hardline has half of what Battlefield 4 had, and in many cases, it's even less than that. It is half a game. And it's missing all of the things that they have put in that make the games better. Where's Levolution? It's gone, unless you count a fucking sandstorm and a crane. It's small little things like this that make it easy to see what this game truly is. If this game was $15, if they just kicked out the fucking shitty single player and just did multiplayer, these modes, it would be amazing. It would be a steal at $15. And it would be one of the best expansions in a long time. Creative, unique, new, sort of like Far Cry Blood Dragon, but just with cops and robbers for Battlefield. That would have been great. Hell, maybe bring the single player back, do more tweaks to it, and charge $30. Not 100 and fucking 20, not 70, not fucking 60. It's not worth any of that. The final verdict for Battlefield Hardline is a 5 out of 10. It probably would have got less than that if it weren't for some fun sections during single player. It is unnecessary at full price, and now you have all the reasons why. And no amount of driving around couches or super rare loading animations is gonna make me feel any different. My suggestion is save your hard-earned money for Star Wars Battlefront. Oh, please God, let that be good. Or go back and get BF4 and its expansions now that it's stable. You'll be happier with yourself. But whatever you do, do not pay $120 for this. You will hate yourself. Demand more from your games. Why is that a bad thing? To demand more from your games, especially if you're a huge fan of the series like I am. Can I get at least what we got in last year's $60, $120 game? No. When they come with this lack of content, with this weak single player, with this multiplayer that you're done with, after just a few days, it's your right to say something, to criticize, to help contribute to improving it. Fight for good gaming. Until then, I'll see you guys on the next Angry Joe Show.
That's the sound.
Shut up! Fucking sick of that shit. Every time I get in the car, you turn on the car, the fucking songs, they're already repetitive. All of them. I'm fucking sick of them. It's not in the game. It's missing in the game. Fucking EA, man. Shit.
Hey, Joe, wanna play a cliche cop game? Killer Thanos. Yeah, pretty much.